Good morning, you guys. Welcome to AKQGuy. I threw out a video earlier today. You haven't really seen a lot of me this week, that whole preparing to move and whatnot. And but I have been keeping up on my own subscriptions, and I feel like I want to respond to a couple of them. For when tomorrow, I have heard back from the person who I'd like to feature, and he's kind of given me free will to do whichever song he wants, so I'll be spending some time today looking for that. But, yesterday or the day before, Smileyousee, or just Smiley, put up a new video. It's a response to a young woman's, if you had three wishes, what would they be? And they're unlimited wishes, except for, you can do whatever you want except for ask for unlimited wishes, and ask for someone to come by harm from your wishes. So I thought, it is a good question. I think by giving yourself such questions, you kind of find out where you really want to go in life and what you want to do. And I actually have thought about this before, not in this particular manner. I thought about it in regards to a contest that was out there, what would you do with $1 billion? So number one, for myself, I want $1 billion. I know that poor nice girl that put out this video asked for $1 million, and I would prefer to have a little more. But why I would like a little more than $1 million and have like $1 billion, I just want to explain myself for asking the question. And actually, I thought about this a lot, and I thought about why I would want $1 billion, and I actually have this written down somewhere, in the hopes that that ever comes my way. Not that it ever will. I don't think I have a trade that'll give me $1 billion in a timely manner that would let me do what I want to do with it. But $1 billion, I would put away 900 million of it straight away into invest it so that it returns money every year to start a company on that return. With that interest, I would employ a small staff that would be myself in a director position, probably two grant writers / fundraising people, and I have a couple people in mind that I'd love to employ. That I know here locally that I think would do a fantastic job, and I just love their personalities. They would be the kind of person I would want to come to work with every day. And probably a kind of a secretarial position, answer phones and whatnot, and help organize things, as well as two assistants to my grant writers and my accountant that I would need for accounting law and tax law. And what I would do with this company is every year, if you figure $900 million is put away, it's a non-profit company. We would get, hopefully, somewhere around, maybe, I would hope for a 10% return. Let's face it, that may not happen. 10% return would give us $90 million that we can give away every year. I would like to do it community-based here locally. I want to help those people that don't have a lot of resources. We live in a society that has this very large middle to upper-lower class and lower-middle class people, that there's not a lot of resources for them. There's a lot of resources for being very, very poor. But for those people that are just working really, really hard, what we call the working poor, the ones that are employed, that have a really hard time making ends meet with life's challenges, I would like to be able to be a resource to them. For the ones that really could just use a couple bills paid off, for whatever reasons, medical reasons, you know, transportation reasons, things that, you know, life threw at them and they had to deal with, and they're working really hard to deal with, but they could just use a little help. And I would like to be able to do fundraising. That's one of the two people that are grant writers or / fundraisers, you know, do fundraising for worthy organizations and worthy causes. They'll put on fundraisers for them and help with that. And there also be grant writers for people that are trying to send their kids to school, and maybe they're not incredibly educated themselves, but it's just hard finding the resources to be able to find the money for that, or even for just projects and whatnot, be able to say, well, if this is my staff, I have grant writers, let's work with them, let's see what we can do. I think it'd be great to have that much money annually to just give away to people who need it. I think that would help not only those people, but I think it would be a great return from the community. So, that's wish number one. Wish number two would be for the wisdom and the sincerity to actually do that should I get wish number one. money changes people. I think we've all seen it. Some of us on a very personal level, some of us not on a personal level. But money is power, and power changes people. It changes your perspective, it changes how you think about things, and I hope that I'm above being changed like that and not losing sight of why I would want that money. But, I mean, honestly, $900 million would put away, $100 million would be mine to spend as I see, and I put a little chunk of it away, no more than, you know, $20 million away for my own usage, paying off my own bills, buying my own house, buying my own car, and I'm not looking for a huge mansion. I'd buy a moderate-sized house, and I'd put the rest away for me and my family. And then as far as the rest of that $100 million would be money that I'd give away to my family and friends that I know could really benefit from it. Making sure that my nephews and nieces will go to school. If they don't use that money to go to school, that it will be put away until they would like to buy a house or even a retirement fund, but it will not be just money to be spent and become rich spoiled kids. So I would hope for wish number two, for the wisdom and the sincerity to actually be able to pull that off. And to be able to surround myself, be smart enough to surround myself with people that will help me do that and stay community-minded and not greedy. Number three is really hard. I guess I view it with, if I had that money, what else would I need? So I guess it becomes a wish of, what do I desire? And I can't see, if I had that money, I'd not be able to get what I desire. Not be able to, you know, see something I want and just buy it. So I guess I'm kind of torn. I'd like to go back to school, so I'd like the time to go back to school, or just maybe just the energy to go back to school and finish my nursing degree. And on the other hand, though, it's like, why would I need that? I'd have a full-time career giving away money. Do I need to be a nurse? I guess part of me would still like that as a backup. And also, there's always the question of my lack of musical ability. I mean, yeah, I know how to play an instrument. I have some basic fundamentals in music, but that gene or whatever it is, it's just some people amazing musicians. I'm missing. I don't want to be an amazing musician. I want to be okay. I want to be able to, if I have someplace and somebody wanted backup on something, I could be, oh, okay, I could do that for you. I won't be fantastic, but I can help you out. Or just be able to sing, for God's sake, and not sound like screeching metal. Ah. So, those are my three wishes. And I would like to see what your guys' three wishes are. So please respond to this gal. I'm gonna hope to try and continue to check out her responses to this. You know, in the text, video, whatever. And thank you very much, Smiley, for responding. So I got wind of this video out there from this young girl. I think it's Heather Neva, I think is her name. I'll add it or something, let you guys know, maybe put it in the description. Excuse me, sorry. I'll put a link in the description, whatever side of my screen that is. Anyway, like I said, please respond to that young gal. Let us see what you've got out there, and I hope you all have a great weekend.